Hi, I'm Andrew Miller from Makerspaces.com. This is the first lesson of the bootcamp for the CTE Makeover Challenge. Lesson one will address making in the classroom and how it helps to promote 21st century skills that our students need in this 21st century economy. Okay, let's get started. In this lesson, I will help to answer the following questions. What are the skills that students need to acquire in order to be successful in the 21st century economy? How can making in the classroom strengthen these 21st century skills in students? And how is making in schools tied to career readiness? Before we talk about how making in the classroom can help with 21st century skills, we need to know what are the 21st century skills that are required of students today. Many people and organizations have spoken up about this topic, and most frameworks do agree on the four C's: critical thinking, collaboration, communication, and creativity. In addition to the four C's, there are a few other skills that are needed. They are agility and adaptability, initiative and entrepreneurship, and lastly, assessing and analyzing information. Now that I've talked about what skills are needed for the 21st century students, I want to discuss how making in the classroom can strengthen each of these skills. The first 21st century skill I want to talk about is critical thinking and problem solving. These are important skills to have and are used constantly when working on a complex maker project. With critical thinking, student makers have to recognize the problems in the project and find workable solutions to those problems. When creating something with no written or formal plans, students are forced to draw conclusions and generalizations, which they are then put to the test to find the outcome. In this example, students were asked to design a bridge that will hold a certain amount of weight with only popsicle sticks. Students can use memorized data to help, but ultimately will use critical thinking to solve the problem. The next 21st century skill is collaboration and teamwork. It's important to be able to work solo on a project, but it's even more of a skill to work with others efficiently while collaborating on the same project. Making in the classroom is perfectly suited for developing collaboration and teamwork. Many projects can be built in teams, such as this complex Rube Goldberg machine. Collaborating with others also helps to strengthen another 21st century skill, which is communication, which we'll talk about next. In the 21st century, there are more ways than ever to communicate, including written text, speech, and multimedia formats. Students must learn to communicate visually through video and imagery just as well as they do written and orally. There are many times communication is used in a makerspace, including everything from green screen presentations to sketching out a prototype detailing how the maker project will be built. Communication is essential when presenting your project, but it's even more critical when working in a team. The next skill that students need to have to survive in the 21st century economy is the ability to be creative, imaginative, and innovative. Companies are looking to hire students who can demonstrate these skills because companies themselves need these skills to stay competitive in a global and changing economy. Making the classroom helps to grow and strengthen these skills by exposing them to STEAM projects that let students express themselves through creativity, which helps them learn who they are and what they can do. When designing and making, one of the skills you need to have is agility and adaptability. The reason for this is because there will always be problems and hurdles that need to be overcome during the progression of a maker project. Making can help show that failure is okay as long as you don't give up until a project is realized to completion. The first design may not work, but it teaches you to take the information learned from this failure and adapt it to the problem to find a workable solution. 3D printing is a good example of how sometimes you need to make multiple revisions or iterations to your 3D model in order for it to function as envisioned. A school makerspace is a great place to teach students about entrepreneurship, which is also a 21st century skill. One way to develop this skill is to have a business competition or challenge in which students develop an actual product and then have them use their communication skills to present about it. They can talk about fabrication challenges, pricing, material cost, marketing, and countless other areas of entrepreneurship. You could go another step further and set up a make sale on campus and see who's able to sell the most items. The last 21st century skill needed for students to be successful is the ability to assess and analyze gathered information. In order to solve complex problems in real time, students need to be able to break down a problem, analyze the data, and find workable solutions. These are the skills that companies are looking for in their employees. By allowing students to work on more projects more often in school will help prepare them to be career ready. During the course of a maker project, students will need to stop and analyze their progress, assess any problems, and collect data for further iterations. Next up is a more detailed discussion on how making the schools helps with students' employability and career readiness. Pictured here is the Employability Skills Framework, which highlights the 9 skills that are important and necessary for our students to have in order to compete in today's workforce. These skills include interpersonal skills, personal qualities, technology use, systems thinking, communication skills, information use, resource management, critical thinking, and applied academic skills. Being able to have effective relationships with fellow students and later with fellow employees is a key employability skill, which is a combination of interpersonal skills and personal qualities. Employers want to see that students can work well with others, respect individual differences, and demonstrate leadership qualities. Making in a school makerspace helps to strengthen these skills by allowing students to work in groups and find ways to complete a project using teamwork. When students work by themselves on a maker project, it helps to build confidence when they're able to complete a hard task while working independently with little supervision or guidance. The next set of skills from the employability framework specifically addresses workplace skills. These skills include technology use, systems thinking, communication skills, information use, and resource management. The first skill listed is technology use, and a great place to use and learn about cutting-edge technology is in a makerspace. While you don't need technology to make a makerspace, you'll often find high-tech equipment like 3D printers, laser cutters, and CNC machines. When it comes to systems thinking, makers use this type of thinking to analyze how parts of the project interact with each other to produce different outcomes. One example is a 3D printed part with multiple moving pieces, or robotics platform with many systems that control the whole unit. I've touched on communication skills earlier when talking about 21st century skills, so I won't go into that in this section. The last two skills listed in this set are information use and resource management, which are very important in most careers, and they also have a big place in a makerspace. When working on a complex project or a complicated problem, students must also be able to locate, organize, and analyze information regarding the build of their project. Makers must also practice good resource management by managing their time, money, and materials in order to complete a project on time and with the materials allotted. The last of the employability skills is applied knowledge, which includes critical thinking and applied academic skills. Students who are working on a project that has multiple systems or has a complex design need to use critical thinking and problem-solving skills in order to make sound decisions on how to execute a build. Maker students also use applied academic skills such as reading, writing, math, and science principles to help them formulate a winning design plan for their maker project. This is an example of 2 maker projects that does a good job showing how making in schools is tied to career readiness. These projects incrementally build skills that a student would need eventually when working with an employer. These projects require critical thinking, possible collaboration, creativity, innovation, and adaptability. I'm going to conclude this lesson by highlighting a few of the great makerspace projects that help to teach 21st century and employability skills. A great makerspace project for students is to help enabling the future, which is an example of a project that not only teaches collaboration, communication, and creativity, but also about giving back to those in need by helping to 3D print prosthetic hands. Another great makerspace project is to make a circuit block, which is a great project to learn about circuits. Students can design their blocks using creativity and imagination, and once complete, they can use this block interchangeably to run different systems like lighting, motors, and buzzers. Paper circuits are another fun project for your makerspace, which helps to teach the basics about circuits while allowing makers to be creative and imaginative. If you want to get students to think critically while also thinking about alternative energy, you can have them design and make a vehicle powered by air or solar using simple or repurposed materials. Have them work in groups for more elaborate iterations, and then compete against the other teams. This is a great project or challenge when you really want your makers to think critically as well. Have them design a chariot for their Spiro, which is a mobile device-controlled robotic ball. Students will need to be innovative, creative, and will need to adapt to problems that they find when constructing their chariot so it fits correctly and moves freely. An egg drop experiment container is a great way and fun way for makers to learn about engineering and physics while being creative and innovative. The tower challenge is great for teams to work together to design a structure as tall as possible out of materials like toothpicks and marshmallows. I want to thank you for taking part in lesson one of the CTE Makeover Challenge Bootcamp. There are many more lessons coming up, so please stay tuned.